You know, the physics that I used to do was so detached from my life. And if you study the behavior of elementary particles or atomic nuclei, you don't have a clue of doing the important things like how to love your wife, how to love your children, how to behave good with other people instead of feeling jealous all the time. My life challenge at that time was that how to love my wife in a way that she acknowledges it. We will have constantly this battle. I'll say, I love you, and she said, that's all from your head. Can you love me with your heart? I said, what is heart? I have no idea what you mean. So at 1 o'clock in the morning, I was disgusted with myself. So I go outside, and this thought just comes to me, such a liberating thought. The thought was, why do I live this way? And the conviction that came with it is that I don't need to, I don't have to. You know, when I got into quantum physics, I also had the idea that I should do a little meditation and spiritual practice. Maybe then I have some idea of what she means by this heart. And so the combination was very interesting. So I did this meditation for 7 whole days one time. And then on the 7th day, I had a wonderful experience. This experience was life-changing. What happened was that I felt the oneness of everything first. But okay, I have been reading spiritual literature. They all talk about this oneness experience. You feel that all is one. But then what happened afterwards was a big surprise, because I never read anywhere what I felt inside of me that, yeah, I know how to love. I can love anybody. I loved my colleagues who were oppositional to me. I loved everyone in my vicinity, and that power, for 2 whole days, it existed. But unfortunately, after the 2 days, it faded away. 40 years later, I finally discovered the meaning of it. It's the archetype of wholeness I was exploring, that there is no separateness in anything. Everything, every dichotomy can be integrated. And when every dichotomy is integrated, then you have the capacity to love everyone. When I realized that, that problem was solved. So how do we apply quantum physics in our daily life? We pay attention to our experiences that we call inner experience, the experience of the psyche, like thinking, feeling, and intuiting. Changing ourselves and being happy is not enough anymore. I mean, the point is that we are one, right? If you and I are one and you are suffering, that there is something incomplete in my happiness by myself, because you are unhappy and you and I are potentially one. So why can't I act as if we are one and correlate with you and become one, and then also try to establish a situation where you are also happy? Change the world not being separate from the world, change the world by creating examples of transformation ourselves. We change the world by changing ourselves simultaneously.